In this video, I am going to explain 7 structures that can lead to temporomandibular joint dysfunction. I'm going to explain 4 muscles and 3 connective tissues. In first part, I will explain 4 muscles. And in second part, I'm going to explain connective tissues. So, what is first muscle, which is? This one, this is temporalis. Temporalis. Next one is this one and this one. There are 2 fibers in this muscle. This is masseter. Masseter. Okay. The temporalis is on lateral part of head. In usual anatomy book, they describe temporalis much bigger than it looks. The size of muscle depends on people. Some people's muscle can be smaller than it looks on anatomy book. Some people's muscle can be bigger. Okay. Anyway, this is temporalis. This is masseter. These 2 muscles are strong mastication muscle. What is mastication? Simply, mastication means chewing movement, closing jaw movement. Thus, when these 2 muscles get tight, no wonder they affect temporomandibular joint. Here, you know, jaw joint is here, okay? Thus, tightness of these 2 muscles can affect TMJ, very strong mastication muscles, and important for TMJ. Let's go to a little bit deep place. I will explain rest of 2 muscles. Okay, temporalis and masseter are removed. I will explain this one. This is inside part of mouth. This is medial pterygoid. Medial pterygoid. You don't pronunciate the first P letter. It's really a bit tricky, right? Medial pterygoid. This is also mastication muscle. The other one is this one. This is also pterygoid. This is lateral pterygoid. These muscles are not as strong as masseter and temporalis. These size is quite small, but they are important for mastication. It's like you close mouth, then you need to close more, and you need the force to chew foods, then these guys contract. So these muscles are not very strong muscle, but important to bite foods. So important, right? And deep muscles, small muscles mean they are important for stability of joint. You can say same thing for any other joints, like shoulder and hip joints. Think about it. Rotator cuff, it's small, but important for shoulder stability. Think about piriformis, it is important for hip stabilization, right? Same like other small muscles, medial pterygoid and lateral pterygoid are important for joint stabilization. When these muscles don't work properly, maybe that can create temporomandibular joint dysfunction, crucial for TMJ. So I explained 4 muscles: temporalis, masseter, medial pterygoid, and lateral pterygoid. These 4 muscles can lead to TMJ. Now, let me go to connective tissues. Okay, this is medial view from mouth. I was using lateral view from mouth for previous picture. See, this is lateral view. You are looking face from outside. This is inside view. I will explain three connective tissues. This one, and this one. First one is this guy. This ligament connects sphenoid and mandible. Thus, this ligament is sphenomandibular ligament. Simple enough, right? This connects sphenoid and mandible. Next one, this ligament. This ligament connects this process and mandible. This process is styloid process. Thus, this is stylomandibular ligament. Stylomandibular ligament. Very simple. Last one is not actually ligament. That is connective tissue. This guy. This is joint capsule. Okay, two ligaments and one joint capsule. Sphenomandibular ligament. Stylomandibular ligament. And joint capsule. This is my personal opinion. When I work on these three connective tissues and four muscles, people who have TMJ can get better. I cannot guarantee 100% result, but somehow their symptoms can be gone. I have to emphasize, this cannot guarantee 100% result. You know, TMJ is very complicated structure. So that can be from other reasons, maybe a cervical spines, maybe a trauma, maybe head trauma. Many things can affect TMJ. But today's seven structures can relieve TMJ, okay? Very important to know. So let's go to lateral view again and let's see relationship and location of these three structures. Okay, this is lateral view. This is joint capsule. You see styloid process, partially, this is styloid process. Stylomandibular ligament runs like this. Okay, styloid process and mandible. Stylomandibular ligament. Imagine there is sphenoid deep to here, and sphenomandibular ligament runs like this. Okay, this is lateral view, and this is medial view, right? Can you imagine that? So I explained seven structures today, four muscles and three connective tissues. As I said, TMJ is complicated structure. That can be from other reasons besides today's structures. However, it's good to know today's seven structures. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button. Comment and subscribe. See you next video.